Hello everyone, welcome back to 说说 Chinese, 说说中文 I'm Shuo, your Chinese native speaking teacher living in Bangkok, Thailand. I've made a video talking about the differences between all the confusing HSK1 words before. Today, this video is about the differences between all the confusing HSK2 and HSK3 words.There are also some frequently asked pairs of words for more advanced level learners. Let me know in the comments, maybe by leaving a monkey emoji in the comments, and I will make a video talking about the confusing HSK4 and HSK4 plus words. In this video, I will only tell you the most useful and important differences between the words, without talking about too many irrelevant information.
Irrelevant.
Don't forget to like this video for your future study so that you can come back and find this video quickly. What is the difference between 帮助 and 帮忙? 帮助 is a transitive verb or a noun.So you can say, 请你帮助我。请你帮助我。Or, 请你帮助我离开这里。请你帮助我离开这里。Or, 谢谢你的帮助。谢谢你的帮助。Well, 帮忙 is anintransitive verb, and it literally means help a favor. So you can say, 我愿意帮忙。我愿意帮忙。Or, 我愿意帮你的忙。我愿意帮你的忙。And not,懂,明白。If it means to understand what the other person is talking about, 懂 and 明白 are interchangeable. But 懂 can also mean to know a lot about something or somebody. For example, 他很懂历史。他很懂历史。Or, 他很懂我。他很懂我。明白 can also be used as an adjective, which means it's clear. 说说中文的视频讲得很明白。我一听就懂了。说说中文的视频讲得很明白。我一听就懂了。高兴快乐。I've explained different words for happy in this video. Check it out for thorough explanation. 打算计划 Both of them can be used as a verb or a noun. But 打算 is a rough plan. You probably just have thought about it, and you may not really do it. For example, 我打算以后去欧洲旅行。我打算以后去欧洲旅行。Or, 明年你的生日有什么打算吗?明年你的生日有什么打算吗? Well, 计划 is a more detailed plan, and you're more likely to do what you've planned. 我计划用这个周末搬家。我计划用这个周末搬家。Or as a noun, 工作计划、运动计划、减肥计划。Talking about 运动。运动、锻炼。Both of them can be used as a noun or a verb, and both of them can mean physical exercise. But 运动 can also mean sports.
你喜欢什么运动?你喜欢什么运动?
Besides physical exercise, 锻炼 can also refer to any other kinds of exercises. For example, 锻炼语言能力。锻炼语言能力。锻炼大脑。锻炼大脑。锻炼意志力。锻炼意志力。还是或者。还是 is a question word or. 你喜欢喝咖啡还是喝茶？你喜欢喝咖啡还是喝茶？或者 is used in a statement. 我想喝点咖啡，或者喝茶也可以。我想喝点咖啡，或者喝茶也可以。But I also noticed that people in Taiwan, sometimes they also use 还是 in a statement. 我想喝点咖啡，还是喝茶也可以。办法，方法 ,method. When using 办法, there should be a problem first. 这件衣服我洗不干净了。你有什么好办法吗？这件衣服我洗不干净了。你有什么好办法吗？ Well, 方法 does not necessarily go with the problem. 学习方法。学习方法。做牛肉的方法。做牛肉的方法。追女孩的方法。追女孩的方法。必须，必须，必须 means must or have to. 你必须听我的。你必须听我的。And the tone of 必须 is stronger than 要 and 得。你要听我的。你得听我的。你必须听我的。Well, 必须 is an adjective. It means necessary or essential. 别带太多东西了，带点必须的东西就可以了。别带太多东西了，带点必须的东西就可以了。改变，变化。改变 is a transitive verb. So you can say, 你很难改变一个人。你很难改变一个人。Or, 他不想改变。他不想改变。改变 can also be used as a noun. 我看不到你的改变。我看不到你的改变。Well, 变化 is an intransitive verb. 人的体重每天都可能变化。人的体重每天都可能变化。Or a noun. 这首歌有很多节奏的变化。这首歌有很多节奏的变化。In many situations, 改变 and 变化 are interchangeable. But 改变 emphasizes more on the subjective change. Like the subject itself wants to change. Like the previous sentence, 他不想改变。So in this case, you can't say,Well, 变化 talks more about the objective change. 最近天气常常变化。最近天气常常变化。简单，容易 ，easy. 这道题很简单。这道题很容易。But 简单 can also mean simple or not complicated. For example, 孩子的世界很
简单。孩子的世界很简单。
And 容易 can be put before a verb, and it means something is easy to do. For example,
男朋友很容易找，工作不容易找。
男朋友很容易找，工作不容易找。
害怕，
恐怕
，seriously?
恐怕
For the 1,000th time, 恐怕 is not 怕。
其他，别的
，other。
你还有其他的问题吗？你还有别的问题吗
？But 其他 can also mean the rest。
小李、小王，你们跟我来。其他的人在这里等一等啊。小李、小王，你们跟我来。其他的人在这里等一等啊。
一直，总是
，always。一直 is more consistent.
It's like Sisyphus.
一直 rolling the boulder up to the hill.昨天和你分开以后，我一直在想你。昨天和你分开以后，我一直在想你。
我一直不太喜欢他。
我一直不太喜欢他。
Well, 总是 is like this.
It's not like always, always.It's like this.
For example,
他总是第一个到公司。
他总是第一个到公司。
为什么受伤的总是我？
为什么受伤的总是我？
发展，发达。
发展 is a verb. It means to develop.
中国发展得很快。
中国发展得很快。
发达 is an adjective. It means developed.
美国是一个发达国家。
美国是一个发达国家。
适合，合适。
是Sometimes I also get confused.
适合 is a verb.
So you can say, 这件衣服很适合你。
这件衣服很适合你。
合适 is an adjective. It means suitable or proper. For example,
你这么说不太合适。
你这么说不太合适。
虽然，即使。
虽然 ，even though。
虽然我很有钱，但是我也不想买车。
虽然我很有钱，但是我也不想买车。
It indicates that 我真的很有钱。
It feels so good saying this.
Well, 即使 it means even if.
即使我很有钱，我也不买车。
即使我很有钱，我也不买车。
In this case, you don't know 我有钱还是没有钱。It doesn't have this indication.
于是，所以。
I usually explain the difference like this. There are two words,
所以
and就
所以 links the reason and the result,
while 就 links the thing that happens the first and the thing that happens later.
他的室友去了中国，所以他现在一个人住。
他的室友去了中国，所以现在
他一个人住。
Why he lives alone now? Because his roommates went to China.
他的室友到了中国以后就给他打电话。他的室友到了中国以后就给他打电话。
What happened before his roommate called him? His roommate arrived China. Clear enough, right? And 于是 is a word in between 所以 and 就。It emphasizes both the relationship between a reason and the result and the relationship between the first thing and the second thing.
他的室友去了中国。于是他也去了中国。他的室友去了中国。于是他也去了中国。
Why he went to China? Because his roommate went there. And what happened before he went to China? His roommate went there first.
经常常常
These two words are really, really similar. And the difference is so slight that I don't think you need to know them. So just remember,
经常常常 are interchangeable. 我经常去看他。我常常去看他。经过通过。经过 means pass by.
So you can say, 我开车经过了你的家。
我开车经过了你的家。
通过 means to pass through. So you can say,
火车通过了山洞。火车通过了山洞。
经过 can also be followed by an event or a period of time, means to have passed a certain process.
经过了三个月，他的身体慢慢好了起来。经过了三个月，他的身体慢慢好了起来。经过检查，这台机器没有任何问题。经过检查，这台机器没有任何问题。
While 通过 means someone goes through some efforts or uses some method to achieve a goal.
通过努力，我获得了成功。通过努力，我获得了成功。我通过说说中文的视频学习中文。我通过说说中文的视频学习中文。
And 通过 can also mean to pass the exam.
我通过了 HSK3 考试。我通过了 HSK3 考试。然后以后后来。
然后 means then.
我八点起床，然后我就去工作了。我八点起床，然后我就去工作了。
以后 can be used after a certain action.
起床以后，吃饭以后，当了爸爸以后。
If you use 以后 on its own, it means in the future.It doesn't mean then or after.
以后你有什么问题就来找我吧。以后你有什么问题就来找我吧。以后不要再迟到了。以后不要再迟到了。
后来 means afterwards, but we only use 后来 to link two events that already happened.In the past,
他们在一个书店
遇见了。后来他们就结婚了。他们在一个书店遇见了。后来他们就结婚了。Alright, so these are all the content of today's video. If you like this video, hit the like button. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss out the great chance to improve your Chinese. I'm sure from 说说 Chinese. I will see you in my next video. 再见!